Hello friends, welcome to this new video on MongoDB indexes. This is in continuation of my previous video on MongoDB indexes. In previous video, we have discussed what are indexes. We took an example also. Now this video, we are going to talk about types of indexes. What kind of indexes are there, right? As well as I'll do a hands-on and give you some hands-on exercises for you to perform. So type of indexes, how many type of indexes exist? Let us see. Single field indexes means there are many fields in our collection, but all of the fields are not used in our queries, right? Or there is one field which is primarily used in most of our queries, right? So we can create an index on that particular field. If you look at the rightmost column, here we are going to create an index on student ID. How to choose an index, that we are going to see in future slides. But for now, you just remember how many type of indexes are there. Alright, let us move further. Compound indexes. As the name signifies, that we have more than one field involved in it, right? So one thing which I would like to share here is that field name 2, right? This one represents the ascending order and the minus one represents the descending order of this, right? So here this example creates an index, right? Student ID in ascending order and status also in ascending order, right? So it is compound index. And please note that the order of fields listed in a compound index has a significance. So you will have to mention the same sequence in your queries in order to get advantage of this index. Otherwise, index will not be used. We are going to see in the hands-on section of this video. Next is multi-key indexes. Right, so as we have seen in previous videos, or as you know by now, that MongoDB has array field also, right, or array of objects, right? So how can we create an index on those array fields? The good news is that we need not to worry about that. If we are creating an index on that field, MongoDB automatically takes care of that part. So we need not to bother about that, how to create an index which has multiple values assigned to it, right? Inside our field, db.students.getIndexes. This is how I can find out all the indexes in my collection. If you notice, I have only one index, which is a default index created when we create a collection, right? That is underscore ID. We want to create an index on student ID field. So if you look at this, create index, student ID 1, number of indexes before 1, number of indexes after 2. Let us try to run that get indexes command again. And now you can see that version 2, student ID 1, right? The key is student ID. Name of this index is student underscore ID underscore 1. And again, namespace is the same. Now let us see how many fields we have inside our student's collection. So we have these many fields: student ID, name, personal detail, status, right? If you remember from my previous videos. Let us try to create a compound index as well, and status equal to 1. This is how we can create a compound index. Again, you can see that number of indexes before, number of indexes after. 3. Let us run that get indexes command. Third index has also been created with key as student ID and status. By default, the name of this index is the keys, right, the order in which we want to get the results, and then another field, and then again it is ascending or descending. This is how the index is getting named. Let us move further and see what other type of indexes we have to discuss. We have text indexes also. Now, what is the purpose of having text indexes? It supports searching for string content in a collection, right? So we may have some remarks column, some other columns present in our collection or in some fields, right? So we can create text indexes to perform full text search or to perform search on those fields. This is how we can create an index for that field name, and this is the text, right? So this represents that the index which is going to be there on this field, it is of the text index type. And if you look at this, we are creating an index on remarks field, right, like the text index. And when we want to search this field, right, so it can be searched like search nice, right? Please note that there cannot be more than one text index in a collection, right? And these text indexes do not store language specific stop words. For an example, in English language we have the, a, or, is, am, are, right? All the verbs and all are considered as stop words. So while indexing these terms, MongoDB automatically removes those stop words from that particular language. And geospatial indexes are also there, which we are going to see in coming videos, right? I am planning to create a separate video for that, where I am going to discuss specifically about geospatial indexes, what kind of geospatial index look like, coordinate data, right? But here in this, I am just giving an example that the data should be in JSON format, right? And the indexes can be in two types. One is 2D indexes, which are traditional indexes supported by MongoDB. And these days, MongoDB supports both of these, but the latest version of geospatial indexes, 2D sphere indexes, that use spherical geometric to return the results. On the right hand side, if you look at example, this is field, and here we have to specify that what type of GeoJSON it is. It could be point, it could be some other kind of GeoJSON type, right? And coordinates, and we have to give some latitude, longitude kind of information. So here, this is the name of field, location, it can be anything, and type is point, and coordinates, we are saying that these are the two coordinates, and GeoJSON type is this. And this is how we can create an index location field. You can say that it is location, and the index is type 2D sphere, not 2D indexes, right? So let us look at the hands-on part of this, where I am going to cover the text indexes. I will show you the text index part of that. This is the command which we can use: remarks on students collection. Remarks is the field and text is the type of index. And if you see, number of indexes before, number of indexes after, right? Now let us try to create the text index once more on name field and see, does it create or not? And if you see, it says that remarks text, right, already exists with different options: text index version 1, text index version 3 already exists with different options, right? So we will have to drop this and recreate in case we want to create a text index on some other field. But that is not a recommended practice, right? Now let us try to search this index. Students collection as usual. Dollar text to represent text index. What do we want to search? We want to search noise, right? So there are two documents where this nice word is present. You can see here, right? Nice, right? Student ID 9, student ID 10. Let us try to find good, right? Again, student ID 9 and student ID 10. And if we try to find good student, that also matches it, right? If we try to find good student youth, then also it matches 9 and 10. If you notice, it either matches good or matches student. Now let us try to find this exact term. You see, now it is not returning any result because this whole phrase does not exist anywhere as a combined text, right? So that is how we can query a text index also. Because of video duration is getting longer, so with this I would like to end type of indexes part here. I will create a new video to discuss index properties and other aspects of indexes. How can we improve the performance using indexes? Can indexes improve the performance, or it can badly impact the performance? We will see that in future parts of index videos. So see you in future video. Thank you so much for watching this video. Let us meet in next part of this video. Thank you.